हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम वंस मोर टू ऑनलाइन वीडियो क्लास फॉर आईसीएसई क्लास 10th कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशंस। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज फंक्शंस। ए फ्यू टॉपिक्स वी हैड डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस थ्री वीडियोस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट व्हाट इज पास बाय वैल्यू और कॉल बाय वैल्यू, व्हाट इज पास बाय रेफरेंस और कॉल बाय रेफरेंस, व्हाट इज ए प्योर फंक्शन एंड व्हाट इज एन impure function. So starting with the first topic, that is pass by value. Pass by value is a process of passing copy of actual parameters to the formal parameters. If any change is made in the formal parameters, it will not reflect on the actual parameters. It is used when we call a function from another function. So in the caller method, whenever we pass any value, that is known as actual parameters. Those values are received by formal parameters which are present in the method called. So if any change is made in the formal parameters, then it will not reflect on the actual parameters, means actual parameters will not change if formal parameters are changing. Now when this pass by value or call by value process is applicable, so whenever we pass primitive type values while calling a method from another method, primitive values means byte, short, int, long, float, double, char, boolean. So when these type of values are passed, by default they are passed to the method by using pass by value system. With one program we will understand it. I have already designed the program in my system. Let us see that program. We have a class here, pass by val. First method in this class is void show, which receives two arguments, int x and int y. Show is a non-return type method. Because of this void keyword, it receives two integer arguments. So here x and y are known as formal parameters which will receive the value when this function is called from the caller. Now in the body of this method, x and y is updated by 2, means 2 is added in the value of x and y. Now after the update, we are printing the formal parameters, that is x and y value are printed. So that is the simple method void show. One more method we have in this class, it is a static method, static void main. It is also a non-return type method. Because of this keyword is void, static keyword makes sure that this function will become the main method. So after the class is compiled, when we right click on the class, main method will be available for use without creation of object. Now when we execute the main method, 5 and 6 is stored in A and B. Since we are calling a non-static method void show inside static method, that is main, so creation of object is required. So here for creating object, we need to write the class name, object name equal to new keyword, then class name with blank parameter list. Now we can call the method show using this object OB. Now when this line will execute, this is the most important line. When we execute main method and when this line executes, compiler will search for show method in this class. So it will find this show method present here. For calling a method, three conditions has to be fulfilled. First one is the name of the method should be correct, means that method should be present. Second condition is the method called receives how many values. That number of values should be passed from the caller method. So here show receives two arguments, and in the caller method we are passing two arguments. So number of arguments received is matching with the number of arguments passed. Now third condition is the data type of the formal parameters, which is x and y here, should be matching or equivalent to the data type of the actual parameters. So x and y both belong to integer type. Here x and y are formal parameters. Now in the caller method, the value passed, that is a and b, it also belongs to integer type. So the data type of actual parameter, which is a and b, is equal to the data type of the formal parameter, which is x and y. So all three conditions are fulfilled. It means this function will be called without any problem. Now we are going to focus on the call by value method. As we have already seen, whenever we pass primitive type value, that is any type that belongs to primitive data type, that is byte, short, int, long, float, double, char, boolean. Here we are passing integer value, so it belongs to primitive type. In this case, it will be passed to the method by pass by value system. And in pass by value system, copy of actual parameters, which are a and b. So copy of a and b will be received by x and y. So x will store a, y will store b. A means 5, b means 6. Now x and y will become 5 and 6 respectively. When this method block will run, both x and y will get incremented by 2. So x will become 5 plus 2, that is 7. Y will become 6 plus 2, that is 8. After that we are printing the value of x and y. So obviously it will print the updated value, that is 6 and 8. So that is the explanation of this function show. So when this line will execute, that is function call statement, then the above function will be called. A and B will be sent, and copy of A and B will be received by X and Y. And after updating X and Y, it will print the updated value of X and Y here. So here we have made change in the formal parameters. We have updated the formal parameters. So 5 and 6 changes to 7 and 8. Now we have printed the formal parameters. Now after the function call statement is over, if we want to print the original value of actual parameters, that is A and B. So in this case, A and B will have the same value 5 and 6, because whatever change is made in the formal parameters, it will not reflect in the actual parameters. Or we can say formal parameters do not change the value of actual parameters. So this is the whole process of pass by value system. Now we will see the result of this program. Main is already static method, so we can run it directly. Now you can see here, when we are running the main method, Because of this function call statement, show method is called and 5 and 6 is sent. And in the show method you have already seen x and y will receive the value of a and b, that is 5, 6, and x and y will get updated. So 5 will change to 7, 6 will change to 8. Then we are printing the value of x and y, which is formal parameters. So first output you can see, we are printing the formal parameters, which is updated value 7 and 8. When this function call statement is over, then we are printing the actual arguments, which is a and b. So second line you can see a and b remains as it is, that is 5 and 6. It proves that if we make any change in the formal parameters, then it will not reflect on the actual parameters. So that is the method of pass by value or call by value. I hope it should be clear to you now. Now we will proceed to the second topic of today's session. That is pass by reference. Pass by reference, or we can say call by reference. Pass by reference is the process of passing the reference or address of actual parameters to the formal parameters. This is the change in pass by value and pass by reference. In case of pass by value that we have covered just now, while calling a function, when we send a value in the caller method, that is actual parameters, so formal parameters will actually receive the copy of actual parameters. But in case of pass by reference, formal parameters does not receive the copy of actual parameters. Actually, formal parameters receive the address or reference of actual parameters, or in other words we can say that the reference of actual parameters are shared by formal parameters. So when it happens, whenever we pass non-primitive type value during function call, then it will be passed by using pass by reference system. So when non-primitive values are passed, we have two cases here, when we pass a object or when we pass an array. Then in these two cases, reference of actual parameter will be passed to the formal parameters, or we can say formal parameters will share the same location or address of actual parameters. During pass by reference operation, if any change is made in the formal parameters, it will be reflected on the actual parameters. Its meaning is, if formal parameters are updated, then it will also update the actual parameters. Now with the sample program we will study it. I have designed the program. We have a class here, impure fn underscore pass by ref. Since it is a impure function, so I have designed the class name like this. We have one function here, void add. This function receives an array sda of integer type. Name of the array is x. Now in the body of this method, is loop variable, p will find the length of this array x. I equal to 0, I less than p, I plus plus. We are covering the index of all the elements of the array. Since indexing starts with 0 and the last index will be 1 less than the length. So this loop is designed in such a way, starting with 0 and last value will be less than q. So it will cover all the index of this array. Now in the body of the for loop, xi equal to xi plus 2. It means all the elements of the array are updated by 2. So we are incrementing 2 in the value of every element of the array. And after increment, we are printing the value of all the elements of the array. So with one message, change during function call. So again, we will control the loop with the same syntax. Here we are printing xi. So all the elements of the array x will get printed one by one. So here we will get the updated value of all the elements which are incremented by 2. This is the operation done in add method. It receives an array of integer type. Each element of the array is incremented by 2. And after the update, we are printing each element of the array. That is the whole process. Now, in the main method, which is a static method, we have stored 4 elements in an array A. J is loop variable, Q finds the length of the array. So in this case, Q will be 4 because of 4 elements. Since we are calling non-static method from in static method, so creation of object is required, that is class name, object name equal to new, again class name with blank parameter list. Now after creation of object, we are calling add and passing A. So whenever we pass a array, we simply write the name of the array. We don't write the bracket here. Now A will behave as actual parameter because we are sending the value in the caller method. So compiler will search where is add method. It will find that add method in the same class here. Then it will check how many arguments it receives. It receives one argument. And in the main method, we are passing one argument. So number of arguments received is matching with the number of arguments sent. Now the third criteria for the function to be called is the data type of the formal parameters should be matching with the data type of the actual parameter. So here formal parameter is an array of integer type. Actually it is SDA. And in the actual parameter we are passing a array of the same type, that is int. Now all the three conditions are satisfied for the function to be called. Now in this case, since we are passing array, I have already told you when we pass non-primitive type values, that is an object of or an array, then it will be passed to the function by pass by reference operation. And in that case, the reference of A will be sent rather than the copy of A. So reference or address of A will be sent, which will be received by X. Or in other words, we can say X and A will share the same location or reference in the memory. Now when this block will run, add method block, we are incrementing each element of the array by 2. So since we are passing the array A, array A has values 3, 6, 8, 9. So here array x will also have the same value 3689, and because of this length function, length will be p will store 4. Now loop will run 4 times from 0 up to 3. So we will cover all the index xi equal to xi plus 2. Each element of the array will get updated by 2. Now we are going to print the value of all the elements with the same loop. So here each element of the array will be updated by 2. So we will get the updated value. After this method call is over, now we want to print the actual arguments. So arguments after function call. So here we are controlling the loop with j, j equal to 0, j less than q, where k is the length of array A. So q will also store 4 because of 4 elements here. Now we are printing all the elements of A. So here actually we will not get the same elements 3, 6, 8, 9. The reason is whenever we pass an array during function call, if any change is made in the formal argument that was done here, all the values were updated in this add function. And since formal argument, that is x, shares the address or reference of actual argument, if any change is made in the array x, same change will be reflected in array A also. So when we print the elements of array A, we will not get the original value, that is 3689. Actually we will get the updated value that is same as array x. So whatever we get here, same thing we will get in the actual argument also. Now we will see the result of this program. Now you can see change during function call and arguments after function call. You can see here we are getting the same value for the actual argument also and formal argument also. I hope it should be clear to you now. So today's session is over now. We have discussed pass by value, pass by reference, now what is pure function and what is impure function. A function which returns a value to its caller module is called as pure function. It is also called accessor method, as it does not change the state of an object. So whatever function we have designed just now in the pass by value system, now see here, in the pass by value system we had designed show method here. So this show method will behave as pure function, because if any change is made in this function, it will not reflect on the actual argument. So x is updated here, but actual argument A will remain as it is. Now in the main method, when we call show method by passing a and b. So a and copy of a and b is passed by pass by value system. X and y will become 5, 6. 5 and 6 becomes 7 and 8. After update, we are printing the value. And after printing the value, when we print the actual argument, that is a and b, so a and b will not change. So in this case, show method behaves as pure function because it will not change the state of an object, or we can say it will not change the actual arguments. But in the case of second program that we have just now seen, when we pass an array, like here in the main method, when we pass an array, then the address of this array or reference of this array is passed to the formal parameters. And in the add function, we are updating the value of each element of the array. So whenever update is done in the formal argument, then same is reflected in the actual argument also. We have seen the output here. Formal arguments and actual arguments are same. So why it happens? It happens because of this add function. So here add function behaves as impure function, as it changes the state of an object, or we can say it changes the actual arguments also, or updates the actual arguments. Now revise all the topics that we have studied. In the next video, we will cover the last topic of this chapter, that is function overloading. Till then, take care. Thank you.